everyone. Shua Fan here, application engineer at SonTek's. Today, we're going to be talking about when to actually perform a compass calibration with your S5 or your M9. Some of you might know this guy, and some of you might know what he's doing, what we call the compass dance. So when do you actually have to do this goofy dance? For discharge measurements, bottom tracking only as your reference does not use the compass. But if you use your GPS as your track reference, you must have a calibrated compass. So obviously the exception here is that if you are using a GPS compass for your heading information, just disregard that statement. But we're going to assume that you're using a standard M9 setup with the internal magnetic compass in here. So that being said, the best practice is to actually do a compass calibration at every new site. So why is that? So if you're following anything similar to USGS protocols for moving boat measurements, you're required to do a moving bed test before your discharge measurement. So if you're using a loop method for your moving bed test, this requires a compass that is calibrated. And then, secondly, if you have a GPS-enabled system, calibrating the compass lets you use the GPS track as a reference, just in case you have bottom tracking issues during your measurement. So just remember that you can always switch track references after you're collecting the data, but you can't actually do that. You can't actually use your GPS track if you don't have a calibrated compass to begin with. One thing to keep in mind is the magnetic declination for the compass, not necessarily compass calibration related, but another important factor for your magnetic compass. And this value, the magnetic declination, depends on your location. And again, you can enter this in after the fact in post-processing, but just know that you should know that variable at some point during your measurement. So again, to wrap up, for the best practices, always calibrate your compass at each new site. If you want more information on things to consider during your compass calibration, how to do that goofy compass dance, or just how to perform one in general, step by step, you can see our website for more information. That's all for today, folks. Thanks for joining. We'll see you next time.